Pine is an open-world action-adventure simulation game from Twirlbound. The game is set on the island of Albemarle, home to five different tribes of anthropomorphic animals. Humans haven't been seen among them for generations, until your character Hugh tumbles down from the cliffs following a tremor. Though you are unscathed, your tribe is in dire need of a new place to live, so you set out to learn about the land and the ever-changing relationships between its denizens. Albemarle has a long and forgotten history that will need to be unearthed in order to reach your goals, and the story is compelling enough to push you through its roughly 20-hour campaign. Hugh was willing to do whatever it takes to help his people, even if that means playing the other tribes against each other. The tribes can be hostile, neutral, or allied with each other, and your actions influence your standing with each one. The simulation aspect of Pine is rooted in its barter economy. There is no currency, but items and materials you find can be donated to villages. This will raise your standing with them and allow you to trade with their vendors. You'll also discover ideas, which are essentially blueprints to craft new items, armor, and weapons. The most important ideas can be seeded into villages to sway their behavior to your needs. An early mission in the game tasked me with crafting a development plan that would make the tribe I donated to advance in technology. A later one had me spread a rumor of a coming storm to force fearful tribes to cooperate. I love the concept of manipulating tribes through social engineering, but in practice, the seeded ideas feel underwhelming. Rather than spreading discord through a tribe, introducing a poisonous meat recipe just acts as a roundabout way of applying buffs or debuffs to specific villages. Helping villages advance and take over territory will change how often you see their gatherers and guards patrolling the surroundings, but those changes serve little to no purpose. The game has very few side activities, so you'll rarely need to engineer any societal conditions unless the game directs you to. Missions often make you sabotage tribes you've just built relationships with, undermining any sense of ownership over the world state. The most disappointing aspect of the game is the combat, which is meant to allow enemies to learn from your habits. Hugh keeps the same handful of combos from the start of the game, regardless of what weapons he's using, limiting what the AI could even adapt to. Spamming the same thrusting attacks or headshots from a distance rarely forced enemies to block or counter, and it all feels sluggish and imprecise. Other than the five tribes, there is one hostile enemy type in the world, and the rare boss fights seem like afterthoughts. Exploration feels rewarding. In addition to the room-sized puzzles accessible through the main missions, you can discover small ones in the world that get you new ideas. Unfortunately, many of these rely far too much on wonky platforming. Visually, Pine's world is big, varied, and beautiful, but it's full of rough edges. The camera can sometimes get stuck in aiming or map views, and sound effects looped when I used a particular item. However, the soundtrack is subtle but phenomenal. Even with a pre-release patch to address some issues, there's a lot to improve upon. But overall, I enjoyed Pine and its story. I would love to see its simulation gameplay go deeper. The game is out October 10th for $25 on Nintendo Switch and PC.